Well, good morning and welcome to your Sunday Gardener. I'm John Collins along with Carrie Engel.
Good morning.
Battleview Farms. We're in front of the pond, or maybe some might call it a lake. This is a lot bigger than most backyards would see. But today we're going to talk about fish.
We are.
In the garden.
Yeah, fish are wonderful. I mean, first of all, they're just fun to watch. They're exciting. They give you a little bit of color in the garden. They also are great.
Food there to see.
Give them a little, yeah.
A little more in the...
They're going to keep your mosquito population down and go for some other things. Come on, guys. Oh, here they come. They're finding us.
There they go.
But one of the things that's important with fish is to know when to feed them, when to stop feeding them. So one of the more important tools you're going to have as a water gardener is a thermometer.
Right. So this is the key to when and what.
Exactly. So there are different foods for different seasons. And we usually start off, like right now, they're getting a summer food most of the time. And as we transition into fall, when temperatures here get to be about 60, 70 degrees or so in the water.
So when the water temperature in the pond drops below 70, let's say.
Yeah, we're going to say, 60, 65 up to 70 in there. Then we're going to transition over to a spring and fall diet. And it's just, they don't need quite as much to go on. And then as we get into winter, as we get down below about 42 degrees, they're not going to need any food at all. And it's tempting because you have some warm days in January or February and the fish may come up and look for food, but you really don't want to get them started because you want their metabolism or whatever to sort of slow down.
They go dormant in the wintertime, right?
They really do.
Well,
they
not tend totally dormant, but the metabolism slows down to the point where it's kind of like hibernating or something.
Exactly. You certainly don't see this frenzy in the wintertime.
Right.
So that's for darn sure. So just be aware that there's some different diets out there.
Well, it also reduces pollution in the pond, right?
Absolutely.
I mean, the higher energy food produces a little more pollution. Then you get to the fall.
Exactly.
And there's a little less of that stuff.
A little input and output. Yeah.
Yes.
It's kind of, it brings it all around. Now, we do have seminars here on winterizing your pond in October. Mm-hmm. Go to our website at valleyviewfarms.com. I believe it's October 8th. So if you want to know anything more about what to do about your heaters and anything else.
And we'll talk a little bit more about that. We're not ready for the heaters yet.
It's a little early.
Yeah.
But September's upon us, or pretty darn.
Yeah, absolutely. We get some mail, right?
We did. I like this one. This was a question I didn't really have the answer to, so I had to go look it up. John and Carrie, could you guys answer the following question? This is from Jenny and Clyde. And they have a few large oak trees that every year produce more and more little round acorns. Is there anything they can do to stop the trees from producing the acorns and still keep the trees?
The best of both worlds?
Yeah. I'm going to say nothing easy.
Really?
I mean, you could get up there and pick all the flowers off. I guess. The other thing you can do, call somebody like Bartlett Tree Experts or one of the other tree experts out there. Make sure you're working with a certified arborist. And they can actually spray a growth inhibitor or whatever, something called Florel or some different things out that could stop the flowering or just really slow it down so that you don't get the fruit production. So there are things out there. But I just want to put out there, acorns are such great food for squirrels and chipmunks and ducks and everything else out there.
Another thing sits in the back of my head is don't mess with Mother Nature.
Well,
don't hurt the tree, because the oaks are valuable trees.
With earthquakes and hurricanes as of late, I'm with you. I'm like, let it be.
Okay. Carrie, thanks for joining us this morning
Thank
on
you.
Sunday Gardener. And next Sunday, we'll be back with more. We'll see you then. Here, fishy. Here.